my channel, and if you are new here, I'm Noemi, and today I am just going to have a very quick update where we are with the remodeling, and today I'm going to show you the kitchen. Hi you guys, so I am going to show you around in the kitchen today, and this is not gonna be a detailed tour because we are not done yet, but we are definitely closer and we are definitely seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. So I'm going to start here. This is just the area where we having the lunch, breakfast and dinner. And we are still thinking to adjust this table. That means my husband needs to make a long, narrow table over here or just have a one round shape one. We haven't decided yet. We wanna see how it works out. This one. And the big change. Ta-da! The door is gone. So finally we had this dragged project where we used to have a door over here. So this is not a finished final look that you see now. We are going to finish up on the back, and also it's gonna be a cabinet, so it's gonna be white from this side all the way up till the ceiling. So at least I'm going to get a little bit of a storage on the top with the doors. Not gonna be visible as it is now. And so the door now that takes us to the garage, it's over here, and this is opening from the living room. And yeah, so we just simply moved that door. Actually, this is a different door, we got a brand new door, but we moved the opening from where the refrigerator was to here. And so once we figured out the table situation, we can put up a light above it. And then for now, this is where we are now. And what we have to do besides the cabinet that I told you about, that we're trying to finish it up, we also wanna add tiles to the wall until the ceiling. But in order to do that, we have to change the window. So see, this is how it's kind of like a snowball effect. Like if we do something, we have to do something else before we do that. This is how the situation is now. So we also missing the kickboard down there, which is fine now. I mean, it's no biggie. And so right now we have just the shelves up there, no upper cabinets. And I have to tell you, we might going to stick with that because I just love it. It's so much easier. And as I mentioned, I always left open all the upper cabinets. That was a hazard to my family. So this is far, far better in my situation. And I have to tell you, I save so much time not opening and closing the cabinets. I can't even tell you. I never thought that I spend time with that, but yes, it does require time to every time when you want something, you open the cabinet and you close the cabinet. But that way, when I cook, I can just grab and reach wherever I need immediately, and I tend to be more creative with my recipes when I'm creating all these foods because I see what I have and it gives me idea to use them. So yeah, and these are just the shelves from IKEA. Yeah, so I get to see all what I have, and my my younger one is eating raspberry outside. So the next project that we have to do is we have to change the window. We already have a window that we're going to put in. So it's gonna be nice because I'm going to have a screen there on it. Right now I don't have a screen, so I got all kinds of flies and mosquitoes coming in. But it's okay, it's fine. And I love the thing that I have. I can only just tell you good things about that. And the countertop is dreamy. If you add a defense to choose what you wanna use, I would definitely recommend this one. So far, everything is working out as it was expected. I love the faucet, I love my sink, and the kitchen countertop, you guys, this is like a dream come to me because before I had a tile as a countertop and I had so many grout that was coming out and it was discolored, and so this is so much easier to clean. This is amazing. And also I have to give you a feedback on the drawers. I'm in love with these. I'm never going back. I mean, this is so much easier to store things. I can just reach behind it. Before, it was all taking up a whole entire upper cabinet of mine in the other house. So right now it's just one drawer. I love it. It's really, really convenient. And all my spoons and everything that I need for the cooking, most of the stuff is here. And I promise I'm going to make a detailed tour once it's done. I'm going to show you everything around here, how I store them, because I really do love this kind of system that everything is in the drawer. The kids can reach it easily. I don't have to reach and I don't have to pull out the chair to just hop up. So it's definitely the kitchen that I wanted to have so much. And I really like that airy feeling as I'm cooking. I really don't have this upper cabinet. So here's the thing, guys, we're supposed to put up a hood already. We really need the hood, but we don't want to put up the hood before we do the tile work. But in order to do the tile work, we have to change the window. So but we will get there. But for now, I just have the main things, which means all the lower cabinets that we have. And the oven, I think someone asked me about this oven, and this is a smaller version of than the traditional one. So, and it works perfect. It warms up faster. So we use this as a toaster and we warm up food in that. It has a multi-purpose function for me. And because we don't have a microwave, although I have to mention that when we got this oven, it's beautiful, guys. I mean, it's really like a mirror, but you cannot really see where you're turning it to, so it's reflecting so much light that you don't really see what you're doing there. So once you memorize where is that 350 degree, it's fine. But yeah, that's the only downside of that oven. Otherwise, I love it, and I love this cooktop as well. It's very easy to clean. Yeah, that's our lunch, spaghetti. Just a quick update to you, where is the kitchen, because probably you guys were wondering where we are at, but this is where the kitchen is now. So this is gonna be a smoothie corner, as I mentioned before, and I'm going to create a shelf for teas as well. So smoothie corner, tea corner, and spices and more cooking stuff here. Yeah, so this is the big picture of the kitchen now, and once we getting further with the project, I will definitely update you. But right now we are currently working on the fence outside there, So the fence is going to start behind the bushes and it's gonna be all the way to the side of the house. So I hope you liked what you've seen and you get some idea and inspiration, even though it's not fully done because hood is missing, tile is missing, we have to change the window, but you're getting the big picture here that it's definitely a functioning kitchen at this point. So this was for today and I really hope that you get some ideas if you are into making any renovation or just update to your kitchen. And also I'm going to be more regular with the videos. Like, I'm trying to settle down on days when I'm going to post about foods on a different days. I'm going to just post about cleaning and organizing. It's just right now we are just so overwhelmed with the to-do list, and this list, it has major projects on it. Like right now we are recently, just right at this moment, we're working on the fence around the house, and we also have to use a pressure washer on to clean the roof, the gutter and the house, then we have to paint it. So it's all very exciting though, and what am I saying, it just requires so much of a time that I'm trying my best to post on a regular basis as much as I can, and but that's why I'm kind of like posting on the random days, because I never know like what am I getting into, what kind of project at the day. So thank you so much for watching, and if you wanna see more videos like that and you don't wanna miss my next one, then please subscribe down below with the red button if you push it. Also, if you wanna get notified when I post videos, there's this little bell, you can just click on it and you will get a notification when I have up something new video. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next video soon. Thank you, bye!